you want to earn a lot of money? If this is yes, great. Do you want to have a good life one day? If this is also a yes, even better. And the last question is, are you willing to work for it? Then I have the right opportunities for you, because I'm going to introduce to you the 5 highest paying jobs with the business information technology. And that is the reason why I always try to tell you that business information technology, in my own experience, is one of the best opportunities you're going to have if you are willing to work hard, if you want to earn a lot of money. So definitely study business information technology. And the first job I'm going to introduce to you is the Java developer. And Java developers earn about like 70,000 in a year. During your studies in business information technology, you will have to work a lot with Java, because the Java language is a really flexible one. This is especially for people attractive who have the interest to work with different projects, who want maybe to work one day as being a Java developer is a really interesting worker field, because it is, in my opinion, also a really flexible one. Because if you have the interest to work one day as a software developer, then Java development is the right choice for you. And maybe if you say, okay, software development, it's a little bit boring, I do every day the same, I want to create my own game, or maybe I want to work in the gaming industry, for example, then also Java development is needed. And that is the reason why, in my own opinion, Java development can be a great choice, especially for those people who want to have more flexibility in their lives. Let's start with the second job opportunity I have for you, and this is the so-called system administrator. And system administrator earn on the median level about like 75,000. And if you don't know what a system administrator does, I'm gonna explain it just in a few words. So a system administrator's main job is to upkeep and to configure computer systems, for example, like servers. But this is of course not all, because for example, you work with computer systems, you will always have users who need access to those servers. So sometimes you also have to face errors, sometimes you have to face, let's call it, tickets from a users. So if you like to work with users together, if you like to work with your clients together, if you like to work especially with the hardware, then being a server administrator is the right choice for you. Do you want to fight cybercrime? And also, are you interested in hacking? And in this case, if both answers are yes, then maybe information security analyst is the right choice for you. And the reason for it is that big companies, they create, or let's say they work on a daily basis with a lot of sensitive user informations. And that is the reason why they need intelligent, good educated people who gonna encrypt those user information. So because we all know you can be hacked anywhere at any time, and there are also some people who are gonna make money off it by hacking big companies, stealing information. For example, the big Sony company also has been hacked, where millions of user information has been stolen. Also really sensitive user informations, for example, like credit card informations or whatever. And that is the reason if those companies has been hacked, there's of course a lot of publicity, and at the end of the business year, those companies has to face a lot of lost customer trust, and of course at the end of the business year also they lose money. And that is the reason why they spend every year hundreds of millions of dollars to keep those sensitive user informations encrypted as possible to save them. And that is the reason why they need you to save those sensitive user informations. And that's why they pay you around $86,000 in a year. And I think this is a really attractive income. The next working field on the fourth place, or let's say it's the second highest income you can achieve when you study business information technology, and this is a job you're gonna definitely find 2, 3, 4, 5, or 100 people, depends on how many people you know. When you study business information technology, you will definitely meet people who want to work as a data scientist. And I know, especially on YouTube, this kind of job is really hyped up. You're gonna see every time people promote, they say, go be a data scientist, you're gonna earn a lot of money. And this is somehow true, because on a median level you're gonna earn about like $96,000 in a year. So if you don't know what a data scientist does, I'm gonna explain it just in a few simple sentences. A data scientist usually work with raw data, and inside this raw data, he has to recognize patterns, and based on those patterns inside the raw data, he has to make some kind of predictions. So if you really want to have a high income as data scientist, I would recommend you to maybe go to the financial industry, because, for example, big hedge funds, they also hire a lot of data scientists, because based on your predictions, for example, on how a stock is about to perform, they can make, based on those predictions, the right choices to invest into the stock or maybe not. Let's go to the one of the highest paying jobs when you study business information technology, and this job is called data architect. If you decide to work as a data architect, you're gonna earn on the median salary level about $120,000 in a year, which is really attractive. But I have to tell you that being a data architect, to have access to this market, it's not really easy, because you have to understand that as a data architect, I can easily compare you to somebody who's working on an open heart, because you're gonna work with really, really, really sensitive informations about a company, and that is the reason why those companies are not giving access to everybody who applies for this job. So usually those companies are making so-called in-house training, which means that they educate their own employees who have work experience, because you're gonna work with really sensitive informations. Your job is gonna be to encrypt data records, and also you have to take a close look on the legal aspects on how you have to handle those sensitive informations. And that is the reason why these jobs take a lot of pressure, you have like high responsibility, and the reason why not everybody can access this working field. That is why people usually who work as a data architects, there is like a high demand, but you have to imagine this is like being one of the best people in your working field.